Hey guys, it's Layla from Ignite, and in today's video, I'm going to show you a sample introduction answering the 2019 HSC question for T.S. Eliot. But before I get into today's content, please do like and subscribe to our channel and click the bell for notifications. And if you're looking for resources to facilitate your studies in the year ahead, check out our website at Ignite HSC. To walk you through and unpack the 2019 question for Module B, specific to the study of T.S. Eliot, I will then show you a sample thesis statement and an introduction in direct response to that question, so you have a firm idea of how you would not only frame an argument in response to the question, but also embed the key words in the question throughout your intro. So the question from last year's paper read, actually not last year, 2019, people are half alive, hungry for any form of spiritual experience. To what extent does this view align with your understanding of Eliot's poetry? We have another clip where I walk you through in great detail, step by step, on how to write a thesis statement and how to actually respond to this question. But in essence, what we really do need to do is look at the key terms in the question, which I have highlighted here, and unpack them. And when we say unpack them, we need to kind of brainstorm ways of drawing out some sort of meaning from the question's key terms so that you have meat to, I guess, fulfill the thesis statement and give direction to the rest of the essay going forward. So here, when we look at the term half alive, I'm immediately asking myself, well, why are individuals in Eliot's context half alive? I.e., what about his context has enabled individuals to feel this way? So you want to unpack the qualities of his war-struck existential world, and perhaps through that, open scope to more ideas you can raise in your essay. Upon looking at the question initially, you kind of think that you're limited to poems such as, you know, The Hollow Men or Journey of the Magi, because they deal a little bit more specifically with this sense of spiritual emptiness. But your essay needn't be confined to those poems only when looking at this question. You can think more broadly about the context in which Eliot is placed and the reasons for why individuals are yearning for that spiritual direction in the first place. So that deals with that first part of the question. Then we have hungry for spiritual experience. And similarly, you might want to ask yourself, why is the individual hungry? And what is the relevance of this? And you might want to think more broadly about the failure of religion and the lack of meaning that were really central features in Eliot's world. So having had a chat about the question's key terms and how you would unpack it to start to flesh out your intro, let's have a look at what the introduction would actually need to include. So first, you want to frame in your thesis statement in some way a central value you would attribute to the study of Eliot. Now what I mean by that is, as you're kind of going into your thesis statement, inherent in the thesis is the core ideas that you're going to flesh out in the rest of your essay, and you would embed them amongst or just before the thesis statement. So make sure in the first couple of sentences you frame the central value that you attribute to the central study of Eliot, and then you would proceed with the thesis statement. And the previous slide where I broke down the key terms in the question would help you here, recalling that the thesis is the central line of argument that is going to foreground the direction of the essay. So you'll respond to the question in a way that establishes where the rest of the essay will go. You then need to make sure that you introduce your poems, framing their contextual features as well. It's important to date the poems as a formality. You might then like to foreground your reading of Eliot's formal mode in light of the wording of the question. That's not a necessity. You could either frame elements of his form, or you might want to foreground parts of the context that are relevant to the poetry. And then you're going to end the introduction with a clear signposting of the key ideas that will form the basis of your paragraphs. And you should do so in a way that incorporates the wording of the question. So you're starting off the introduction with your thesis, and through that thesis, you're also going to frame the key values that you're exploring. That's going to be inherent in the way that you unpack the key words of the question. Then I need to know exactly what poems you'll be using in your response. Then you can go through and discuss elements of context or form as they are relevant to the question, the key aspects that are going to inform the rest of your essay. And then you should end the introduction with a clear direction of where the essay is going, which means to state the ideas for your paragraphs and do so in a way that incorporates the words of the question. Okay, so let's take a look at an exemplar. T.S. Eliot's modernist world was stuck by a spiritual paralysis. Individuals viewed themselves as fragments disconnected amongst the chaos of early 20th century life. Eliot's alienated archetypal persona reflected individuals who are half alive and plagued by the omnipresence of mortality, confronted by the existential rhetoric of God is dead, searching for any form of spiritual solace. So those first two sentences there are the thesis statement, and you can see how the terms of, you know, the spiritual fulfillment, half alive, have been unpacked and embedded there, but we've done so in a way that is also opening the scope to discuss the backdrop of the poetry, what's happening in Eliot's world. So if you're thinking about the body paragraphs here that might be used to answer this question, there would probably be a paragraph, judging by this thesis, exploring the context, right, the context of mortality rendering individuals half alive, then perhaps one paragraph unpacking why individuals are searching for spiritual fulfillment, so the search for spiritual direction, and then perhaps the final paragraph assessing the viability of that spiritual fulfillment, whether it does actually answer the alienation of the individual, for example, with reference to poems such as Magi. Now the reference to what poems are used in this essay, such as revealed in Eliot's The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock, The Hollow Men and The Journey of the Magi. These poems were composed in a world derailed by the First World War, establishing an air of death as suffocating, rendering the individual half alive. So you can see that not only in the thesis, but throughout the introduction, we've continued to embed the wording of the question. Accompanying the psychological blow of war was the rise of existentialism, with the resounding words of Nietzsche compelling individuals to question traditional spiritual dogmas. Inevitably, the context of loss, paragraph 1, and a consequential sense of internalized alienation, paragraph 2, the individual is left suspended in search for spiritual experience. So that's the exemplar there. I've highlighted to emphasize how frequently you should be embedding keywords of the question to show your marker that you're not shying away from the demands of the question, but you're attacking them. And we've added value there, and we've foregrounded a direction of the essay that can be sustained to answer the requirements of that question. Now, if you're enjoying this content, please do like and subscribe to our channel and click the bell for notifications. And if you're looking for resources to really give you that direction in your English studies, check out our website at Ignite HSC. We have a plethora of resources on all of the different prescribed texts with close analysis, exemplar responses, and they've been informed by state, rank, performing students, HSC markers, and the combination of insight there is just crucial to help you get the results that you want in your HSC. So check out the website, Ignite HSC, but for now, guys, thank